What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and in this video, I want to talk about something that you should be doing when you are applying for jobs. And so I've been getting this question a lot, and this is a question that I wanted to just come straight out and address here, which is people ask me, you know, I've been applying for lots of jobs, I've been putting myself out there, and I'm just not hearing back from companies, right? And this can be so frustrating because it feels like we're doing so much work, right? It feels like we're going through putting in so much effort and we're just not seeing the results. Because, you know, maybe you send out 100 resumes and you get like one response back, right? And it's crazy to think like how much effort we can put in versus how much results we're getting. But what I want to talk to you about today is why this is happening and how you should start thinking differently, especially as an interview hacker, about this whole process and how that's going to help you to have better results when you are reaching out and when you are applying for interviews. So I had a mentor who always used to say that, you know, people would be creating courses or writing a book or whatever, and they'd be worried that someone would steal their work, right? I'm sure that, you know, we've all had this idea when it's like, I have this great idea and I don't want anyone to steal it, right? I don't want to share my idea with anyone because they might steal it, and what if I want to build it, right? But what he would always say is, you should be so lucky that someone wants to steal your idea. And I thought this was really interesting because he's a, you know, New York Times bestseller. He obviously knows a lot about like copywriting your books and all this stuff. But what he would always say is, you should be so lucky that someone cares enough that they want to steal your ideas, right? Because the problem that we have most of the time is not that everyone wants to steal our idea, or not that we want to protect it. The problem that we have is that nobody cares enough to even want to steal our idea in the first place, right? So a lot of times, you know, for example, let's imagine that, and I'm not saying you should go pirate movies, but let's say you wanted to watch some obscure movie. A lot of times you might not even be able to find that online because it's like, it's so obscure that no one even took the effort, no one cared enough to want to steal it in the first place, right? And in the same way, I want you to start thinking about how this relates to your interviewing. Because the problem that most people have is not that they don't have a decent resume. It's not that they don't have the credentials. It's that they just are not standing out from the crowd, right? They are one of, you know, Google receives something in the range of like 2 million resumes a year. It's like some obscene number. And so just think about how much you have to stand out from the crowd for them to even take notice, for them to even care. And the problem is that we tend to approach our reaching out for interviews, and we tend to approach these things in the way that is easiest and not in the way that is going to stand out and make people care. So what I want you to start thinking about as you're going through your interview outreach and as you're going through this process is, how can I do the thing that's going to get me results and not the thing that I can do the most of? So like, for example, with sites like monster.com or any sort of resume drops or Indeed or any of these things where it's really easy to send out a resume, guess what? Everyone is using it to send out their resume, right? They have so many resumes coming through that, you know, the companies can just use these application tracking systems where they just, you know, use an AI, they throw your resume in, and if the AI thinks that you're a great candidate, maybe they'll look at your resume. But the fact of the matter is that you're just one of a million different applicants because you're not doing anything to make yourself stand out. So let's talk about, what are a couple ways that you could actually stand out when you are applying for the job? The first thing that you could do is, you know, think about, how can I form a connection with this company before I reach out? How could I form a connection with the recruiter? How could I maybe, you know, look at the projects that they're doing? How could I contribute to one of their open source projects? How could I, you know, connect with the founder? How could I find something unrelated to work that I could connect to someone at the company with? Like, maybe you are an avid chess player and you realize that the CTO of the company is, you know, a nationally ranked chess player. Maybe you could connect over that. It's something totally unrelated, right? And so maybe you can do something like that, and it sounds, and you're probably going to hear me say this and you're like, wow, that sounds like a lot of work. And that's the thing, is it is a lot of work, right? If you really want to make a splash at these companies, if you really want to break in, you got to do the things that other people are unwilling to do. You got to do that hard work, because what you're going to find is that you may be doing a lot more work, but you're going to get disproportionate results from that work. And so by doing that disproportionately large amount of work, you're going to see much more results, rather than, you may send out your resume to 100 companies and get one response. But you could do, in that same amount of time, you could reach out to 10 companies and actually start making that connection. And you might see two or three or even four of them respond and be like, hey, we'd love to interview you for this job. Just think about how different that is. It's not any more work, but it's more focused work. And that's what I want you to start thinking about. Another thing that you could potentially do is, how could you leverage your network, right? How could you leverage connections? How could you get that referral? How could you go through your university alumni database and say, hey, is there someone in here that has, that works for a company that I'm excited about? Is there something, were we part of the same club in college? Is there something more that I can connect with them on? And can I learn from them? Can I reach out to them and be like, you know, I'm not just going and asking for something transactional, but I'm actually going and asking to learn from them, because people love to share what they know. So these are just a couple ideas, but at the end of the day, it's like, I can't tell you what to do, right? Because if I told you what to do, then all of a sudden it's no longer unique. It's no longer creative. You need to think outside of the box. And so what I want to leave you with today is, I want to leave you with a specific exercise to think about as you're going through this process, as you're thinking about, how can I be different? How can I reach out to these companies and actually connect and actually, you know, make a splash and separate myself from the crowd? And the exercise is simply this. I want you to come up with 30 different ways that you could stand out. And you might be saying like, Sam, are you freaking crazy? Like, I can only come up with like two. How the hell am I supposed to come up with 30? And that's exactly the point, right? The reason that we do this, the reason that we come up with 30 ideas instead of just coming up with two or three ideas, is that it forces us to not self-censor, right? So many times when we brainstorm stuff, we kind of, we're in the back of our heads, we're like, oh, well, that's not a good idea. That's not a good idea. And so we censor ourselves and we have trouble coming up because we're trying to come up with that one perfect idea. But what I want you to do is instead put down every single idea. If you set like some crazy high number, you can't be selective. You can't think through this too carefully. You can't like filter your ideas. You just put every single thing down. You don't have to do all the things, but come up with 30 different ideas of ways that you could stand out in your interview. Maybe you could send like a care package. Maybe you could figure out like, you know, the CEO's daughter is sick and you could send like her favorite cookies. You know, there are a million things that you could do. What are some of those things that you could do? What are some things that you could do that will be unique to you? So I'd encourage you, try and think of 30 different things that you could do and think about how you can stand out from the crowd. Because if you can stand out, if you can do something different than everyone else is doing, that's the way that you're going to be successful. That's the way that you're going to break into these companies. If you're struggling with the interviews, think about how you are unique and how you can separate them yourself. And with that, that's all I got for you. Again, I'm Sam from ByteByByte.com. If you enjoyed this video, please check out our free 50 coding interview questions guide. We cover 50 of the most common coding interview questions so that once you actually land that interview, you can go in there and you can absolutely crush it. I encourage you to check it out. I appreciate you joining me, and I look forward to talking with you again soon.